Right, welcome. It's a third presentation on the data, practical data training for CEO, marketing managers, and sales executives. The first one, we've talked about the culture to recognize the factors to recognize. And gave us assignment in the second video, talking about our vision, the mission, the value proposition, that they should be around the factors that either in line with the factors or reach disruption. Whichever way, we must find a way to come up with something that will either in line or disrupting the factors to get results. Remember, I told us that the number one reason is because we want to make sales, and you have to consider the factors that control sales. So when you are writing your proposition, vision, and mission, you must consider them, because people will not buy what they don't need. People will not buy something that doesn't add value to them. People will not buy what they don't have the understanding that it has value to them. People will not buy something that doesn't explain what they get. People will not buy what they don't have testimony of someone that used or someone they respect that is using. They will not buy. People will not buy something that doesn't add value to them. People will not buy things that are not necessary or important to them or appreciate in their community. So people buy things that are relevant to the 10 factors we mentioned. So your product is an idea, but be sure that idea is relevant to people. It's needed by the people. And if it's relevant and if it's needed, then you must find a way that it gets across to the people. You must find a way that people have the understanding that they actually need that. They need to understand. So you must have a knowledge to pass across around your product, around your services. So like the Bible says that the labor of the fools weary them, for they know not the way to the city, know not the way to the market. Yes, he has labor, he has something good, but reaching out to the right people, the right target. So all these are inside what we've talked about. And to conclude that, moving us to the practical, going to Facebook and others, we'll be having the Heart's Golden Secrets for Robust Return on Investment, as I promised us. So, like I said, this is step-by-step idea. I'm sharing all this because there are stated digital marketing stuff, training, or the paper that people have. But what I'm sharing are from the experiences, what I've tried, how I've seen things happen, I've seen errors, the mistakes, and then the success. I've practiced lots of things. So this all training are the things that I know that if you can put this, if you can put all this in place, you can get results. It's possible. I know companies that spend millions on digital marketing and they are not getting the result. And you see companies that just spend little and they have great results. And there are some products that some stuff that don't even spend and they have results. But mind you, when those that don't spend and have results are likely around celebrities or something in trend. So though most time, if a celebrity picks a product, probably maybe it doesn't collect money, and grace just work, on it, people, it becomes a push. And then sometimes a product can come to time that there is a serious need. So it doesn't, once people just know it's available, the cost, it's need. So they don't need to do adverts, people go get it. There's some product that evergreen. Of course, we know some of them. We'll not be talking about it, but you know there are some products that don't do advert, but you always have to go to supermarket to buy. Because we know of anyway, not doing an advert for them, but we know of St. Louis Sugar. You know that they no advert, they didn't no changing of pack, nobody is talking about it, but you always they keep selling. You always have to go and buy. That product like that, because the needs, and over the years there are some things that they become the regular. So at the same time there are products that you need to run hard, you need to talk about them for people to be aware that, oh, this is available for me. And that's one challenge about many authors. You are an author of a book, you author a book and you take to bookshop. Excuse me, you have your book in the bookshops, but who are you talking to about the book? How do people know that there's a book to meet their main that they need to read? Things like that. Same with some people. So it's not enough to create a product. Getting the product across to the right target to consumer is very, very key, is important. So that's why you need to really consider the first two videos. Consider those 10 factors, look into it and look at your product, your services, develop a value proposition, vision, and the mission that will excerpt from those factors. So that will really help. Now we're talking about ads, golden secret for robust return on investment. There are 14 of them I've tried to put together that's going to help us. Now, when you have these understandings, now, by the time you start to run your ads, you will remember that, oh, before I put money, let me use a group first. Let me join groups. From joining groups, then I can be able to share. So if you join groups, at least you are sure that at least 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000, 100,000 people will see your post first before even talking about money. They will see your post first. Then now running hats, and then you will know, there are things I need to consider when I want to run hats. I need to know this. And then so it gives you better understanding that even if you are not the one doing it, so you will know when someone is doing something for you, be able to check them. Because someone that is not in business, that says it's a data marketing personnel, and you just, it's not in business. A data marketer, somebody that just been trained to handle things, may not. You have to put them through that. No, do it this way, because they just come with the idea of what they learn that they think. Now, I'll be sharing on the golden rules, all the golden secrets. Some things may work in America, they may not work in Nigeria. We have to understand it. So let's move now. Okay. I have to start now. So, but don't forget, this is very key. First and foremost, be sure you are feasible. That's the first golden rule. You cannot say you want to sell online when you yourself are not online. And be feasible on Facebook, be feasible you must be active on all your social platforms. You must be feasible. And the way to be feasible is very key. Number one, you need a very good social platform. Now, when you yourself, the owner, has to go do good setting. If you are in Nigeria, let it be known that you are in Nigeria and put every arrangement, everything that you need to put in place. Put them in place. put them in place. Everything that has to do with the setting is very, very key, is very, very important. So try to do all the setting. Try to do all the setting. Try to do all the setting about you, the age, the phone number, the email contact, everything. Make sure you set them. Set the contact, because that is going to determine your demography. So it's going to determine, and it's going to, that's another way to minimize, to maximize the little you put into heart. Because you can't say you are in UK, you are running hats in Nigeria. I mean, you can understand what they, but you are running hats in Nigeria, you're in Nigeria. You are running hats in Ghana, you're in Ghana. Or you are running hats from Ghana to Nigeria. There are different price charges, and there are things you have to understand. So you must be first feasible. And this is where website comes from, comes in. Now, when you have a very good website, now, there are key things around having website, because by the time there's engagement, it's all this, all the thing about internet is that they work hand in hand. If I go to Google and I type your name, what do I see? If you are active on online, if you are active on internet, if I go to Google, it will show me your website, it will show me your Facebook account and your LinkedIn account, and those three are key. And so it does have the wine, it does have all this work together. So you must be sure that you are feasible. That's number one. That's the first thing. You must be sure that you are feasible. Do and not that you set up and there is no contact phone. There is no, and then some of us, and that is where Google My Business is important again. So you can be able to have map. Some of us we need to have the map of our business place and things like that. So be sure you are feasible. Maximize every tool to be feasible. On your phone, it's funny. Sometimes people off the location on their phone. They don't know how all these things, have the way they work together. The more Google see you effective online, the more you have good ranking. The more Google can see that you are in a location and they know the location, you own your location and you use Google Map, the more, like, it's just like maybe if you follow a page on Facebook, the more you follow a page on Facebook, the more the page recognizes you, and then you can from there win their badge. So the same thing, the more you are active on Google, that Google can see, oh, you are an island, people say, Google can see that you use the Google, the map, you use the app, the more you are on this, the more you become of a Google family, the more that you become a person to other with. And then what I've discovered again is that there are some key events, key programs that if you participate there, now if Google registers you, Google mark and understand that, oh, this person is active. So you must be active. Learn to be active online. Learn to be feasible. Learn to be active. That's the first step. Then number two is build a community around your brand. Build a community around your brand. You know, I remember telling us about joining different groups in some of our trainings that we get there. Build a community. Like on Facebook, there's a personal account, there's a page. Now, people cannot have access for feedback on your page, but you can have access on if you have a group. If you create a group, so build a community around you. Like for us in Empower Africa Project, we have like regular five entrepreneurship WhatsApp group, and then we have Empower Africa Project a group. And because the reason is that people are able to relate. People are able to relate. People are able to get feedback, and then people come. It's a way of bringing people together, and you know, the way of strengthening your demography. So build a community around your brand. Build community. It's going to help. It's going to really, really help you. So build community, then maximize community advantage by joining other groups and promote your brands by contributing, by contribution and content. Join groups. There are millions of groups globally. Join groups. And mind you, when you are joining groups, don't join groups that do, of course, when you join few groups that do the same thing you do for knowledge, for sharing knowledge. Join groups that not do what you do as sales platform. So that's the idea. So for us, of course, we join groups that run the same programs we run, few of them. Just target few that are very good to join that. Then join multiple groups, different groups where any marketing platform where you can share your product, where you can share your services. Join those platforms. And mind you, two things you need to put in mind is that when you join groups, you are not there just to sell. Except it's a platform that is there. When you want, there are ways to sell. For example, people will begin, they may not know you, but let's say you sell something, let's say your product is around F, and now you write different articles, you come up with content that give them solution. By the time they see that you are an institution in that line, when you introduce a product, people will tend to buy this because they know that you know what you are talking about. So it's not just about buy. The way this generation buy is through knowledge. They want to know that, oh, you know what you are talking about. If you really want to sell on internet, you need to understand the power of content creation. You need to understand the power of content creation. You must learn to create powerful content that will drive. So it's not just about, before you introduce a product, like you just find content. Content can be in video, like I watched a comedy skit recently. Now, you never knew that they were about, that the skit was about a product, but you laughed and everything, and inside, that's another way to beat some policies. So inside the skit, they talked about a product. So they used a comedy skit to push product. You must have seen that. So it's about building content. You can write good content about people, health, I say for health, for example, and you probably you sell juice or you have a supplement. So instead of just saying, buy this supplement, you write good content. You can now say, for people like this, one of the solution to the challenge or to this kind of problem is, then you mention the name of the supplement. That this supplement, this is this and this, and this can cure this, it cures him, it's been tested, and what have you need, you can contact me. Now, you are beat. I mean, they, because in internet policy, like for internet policy, like for Facebook, you don't talk about ad product. But in that sense, now you don't run ads, net product. But in this sense, now you have used content to push an ad product, and you discover that you can use your content to push so many products. So by the time you write about the things. For example, you have a school for kids, maybe for you have a crèche. Why not begin to write about why parents should consider where they leave their children at tender age, how to train younger generations and stuff like that. Now, when people see that you have different content that boosting, that really speaks to their mind, they buy your product. They will come to your school. They will patronize you. That's the game. So join groups on Facebook now. LinkedIn too have groups now. Five joint communities, follow, but you are not in, only in follow in Instagram, but follow people, let people follow you. Take the advantage of, I'm telling you this, that these are for, what you do first before bringing in. We're going to talk about paid ads, but before then, don't just go online and say, they say paid ads. There are things you need to know, there are opportunities you need to maximize. So join groups. Like I said, don't forget, join few groups around what you do, good one that you can learn, and then join different multiple groups where you can be able to sell your product. And to sell your product, have content, learn content creation. You can go and you can go to camp, you can find a way. So let find a way, pray, stay. I mean, for me, of course, I always talk about it. My help has been the Holy Spirit, and it's very wonderful that He can always talk to you at any time. When I sit down, I want to talk about something, He gives me words to say, He gives me content. Now, that is for me. Find a way, get content. It's very, very key. Content is key. It's very, very key. So let's move to the fourth one. Content is key, please. It's very, very important to understand it. So, and then don't forget that when you are talking to people online, don't forget that it's not some people will abuse you. You don't have to abuse back. You have to remember that. You don't say because of the way they talk, you will have to talk back. No, you don't do that. Sorry to get this. You don't do that. You have your target, you know where you are going to, you know what you want to do. So you have to stay focused. So of course, you don't expect all 100%, don't everybody to accept you, but some people will definitely understand you. So number four, now 14 rules, don't just run ads. Send ads right. Target your audience. Don't just say, oh, they are there. And I've done that in the past. I just push. But I don't know. That's why you have to set by consider the 10 factors. You have a product. The product you are selling has the right people that use them. When you get online, don't just push and hurt. Look, target the people that push, that need that product or that services. Locate them. So locate those who will patronize you, not just anyhow. So look for the age bracket, the location where those people reside, what is their interest. So you need all those things. Where can you find such people? Where do they gather? You need to get all those things important. And what is their age bracket? All those things are important when you are running an ad. Now, you know your ad and know where it can be featured. That's another one. There are ads that you can't, for example, now if you have a long content text ad, you don't run on Instagram. Instagram does not, there are contents that can only go on Instagram, and there are content that can only go on Facebook. If you have content that you have to explain, you don't run it on Instagram. But if you have a short, you have a video, or you have a picture, it goes on Instagram very well. So you have to understand. And then if you go to LinkedIn, when you are posting on LinkedIn, you don't post like the things you post on Instagram and Facebook. You have to be more, because you have professionals on Instagram, you must write to fit in. Your heart must fit in. So you must know your heart and know where each can be featured. It's not every heart that featured anyway. You have to know your heart. You must know the concept. So that is about knowing your heart and know where each can be featured. Then edit every automated default plan and add suggest. Now I've seen that. Facebook suggests you an ad. Instagram suggests you an ad. Now the point is this: ads that will sell in America may not sell in Nigeria. You have to understand that. So an automated ad that works for India may not work in UK. So when you have an also suggested automated ad, check it, edit it, be sure that you don't just, so you have to check properly and edit every automated default plan and suggested ads. Don't just run it. Make sure you edit it. Make sure you let it fit into your community. Let it fit into your goal, your vision. Let it fit into your audience, your own audience, your own target people. It's very, very important. Then never use without editing Facebook suggested ads. I have to repeat that because I've seen, and I said, because of different location, culture, interest, and behavior. Because of different location, culture, interest, and behavior. Because of that, don't use Facebook ads that is being automated as in suggested without editing, please. Also, let's remember that your ads are not for show and ego, but for sales. Remember that. You are not doing the ads so that they will say, oh, we are running ads now. No, it's not for show. It's not for ego. It's for sales. You want return on investment. So target the right people. It's not about we are running ads. No. Are you getting results from running ads? Now, it's not about I have 1 million likes. It's not the likes you need. It's sales you need. If you have 100 people that visit and buy, it's far better than 1 million likes. 1 million likes will not give you anything. The only people that likes will give, the likes and follow we hear that will boost, is for those who sell their platform, who use their platform to sell for other people. That, okay, if they know that, oh, you have 100,000 followers, or you have 100,000 likes, I can sell on your platform. Beside that, it doesn't help you. Now, mind you, Facebook basically does not, when there is a post, the posts are only shown to people that wait, that stay to read posts on pages. It's not the people that like. What if I like a page, if I don't always stay to read posts on that page, Facebook will not show me their hearts, even despite the part that I like the page. It is when I stay that they show me, okay, they will now be bringing the next one, that, oh, he has interest in this. So don't go after show or ego. Get the target. That's why, like on our platform, we have different targets. Create different targets per product. Create different targets per product. Oh, I think the young ladies will like this one. So so what you do is that create that the target for the young ladies target and push that. So you must learn, that is very, very important, that you are to target the right people for every product. People in your space or your field are not your buyers, but your competitors. Stop looking for them as ad targets. Imagine I want to run an ad and they ask me a target and I said digital marketer. Digital marketers or anybody in an internet company are not my target. So if I choose them, it's wasting of money. So you are in fashion space, you want to sell fashion product, you are looking for people in fashion space, you are except to sell to them. But if you do the same thing, you don't look for them, you don't pick your field as the demography. You don't pick your field as intention or as interest. You don't pick your field. You have to look for people outside. Don't pick your competitors. Stop looking for them as hard targets. Look for those outside your field that will need your product. That's the way it goes. That's how it works. Use hashtag and keywords that invites people who need your product and services, not those in your space. Let me explain something about hashtag. I know so many people don't know about this hashtag of a thing and the keywords. First, let me talk about hashtags. Now, what hashtag means is this. So because I see so many people, they create hashtag. Let me explain to you, and next time you will know how to use hashtag, or else you are just wasting your data. Now, hashtag works in two ways. Now, number one is when there is a trend, there's something is viral. People are talking about answers. So when you say something about answers, you want the people, relevant people of hashtag or answers to know, you will hashtag answers. What it means is that once you hashtag answers, every person that says something about hashtag, that join the hashtag community, will see your post. So if I have a celebrity, and I want everybody around that celebrity to see my post, so what I do is that I hashtag that celebrity. Or if there is a discussion and I want everybody engaging in that discussion to see my post, I hashtag that discussion. So that is number one way of using hashtag. So how do you then use hashtag to sell? So when you have a product that has, for example, you have a product that has to do with sport. So what you do is that you hashtag the celebrity in sport, you hashtag them, you hashtag the institution in sport. So what it means is that the celebrities, those in the community of the celebrities, will see your post. Those in the community of those institutions will see your post. Though, and then you hashtag the trend around the stock, around sport. So those in the community of the trends of something viral will see your post. That is the number one way of doing hashtag. Then number two, the other side of using hashtag, you will see that it's different from the way so many people do hashtag, is you want a discussion to go viral. So you launch an hashtag. So when you launch an hashtag, make sure that you engage few people around you to make their contribution and hashtag that hashtag you launch. So you say ball, you want ball to go viral, you write something now, hashtag ball. So what you do is that to go viral by prayer, of course, whatever, you know, engage 2, 3, 4, 5 people to say something, and then with hashtag ball. That is what makes, and of course it has to be something valuable, something that can valuable in the sense that it to some people is not, that it may not be sensible. Of course, I mean that some things are not sensible, they are viral, but because it's the current talk, is in vogue, is the trend. So these are the two ways that a hashtag works. But I see some people will just write and they hashtag their name. I just laugh. They just say something and they hashtag. You hashtag something that nobody knows it. You have to push it. If you want to launch a new hashtag, you have to push it. You have to make it a discussion. You have to tell people to hashtag. That's how it works. So that's how hashtag works. So what you use is that you use hashtag that relevant to your, you have seen, for example, now, answers may have 1,000, 1 million community. So, and you can't use, you must use relevant hashtag to the product or services. That's another thing. So that's the way it is. For example, now, for this video, if I'm pushing it out, I will hashtag SME, hashtag MSME, hashtag entrepreneurs, hashtag entrepreneurship, because those are my targets for this video. Those are my targets. So I hashtag those. So those in MSME, SME, in business, those in entrepreneurs, they are in their community. entrepreneurship in that community, African entrepreneurship, Nigerian entrepreneurship, anything, any hashtag that has been created, you look for hashtag that has already been created, is going to drive people to your post. That's the idea. Then keywords are actually primarily with Google. So what keywords? You don't create keywords. The best thing for keywords that there are recognized words already, keywords that Google recognize. So what you do is that when you are developing a content, you are writing your content, you bring in keywords, you consider you can search for keywords. You consider keywords are words that are already on Google, already Google recognize them, so that Google recognize them, people use it to find, to search, or it connects to market. So you write with keywords in mind. So when your content is with keywords in mind, so when people go on Google search, when they type it something in line with what you push, it brings it out. So when you are writing, learn to use three things, especially for those of us who have website. When we are writing, consider hashtag recognized hashtag, consider keywords of recognized recognized keywords, the common keywords that Google already have, and then consider external links. For example, if you are writing and you need to talk about banks, go to Google and search for banks. You need to talk about Africa, go to Google and search for Africa and copy the link and put inside that content you are writing on your website. It's a way of bringing the community, it's a way of connecting with community. When you hashtag, when you use keywords, when you do external link, it's a way. So that it's a way that when somebody goes to A, it's going to, from A, they will be able to get to B and C. It's a way of bringing people to your space. So please understand this. And then don't look for green in SEO or Facebook suggestions. It is to them a business. Look for your own business. That is, I've met so many people, they will say, the SEO is not green. No, no. If you want green SEO, do premium. You will see lots of it. So it's not about that. Now, I'm not saying, yes, of course, that's good, but make sure that it's targeting your business. And you target the right people. It may be orange in color, it may not be green, but you will get results by targeting the right people. Make sure you target the right people. Sometimes green SEO may not be your right people in Nigeria, may not be your right people in Ghana, may not be your right people in India, may not be your right people in Korea. There are different places. So target the right people. You understand? Look for your own business. The green in SEO is premium. Everybody is looking for their own business. So look for your own business, all right? So be wise with free boost. Not to just be a waste, but for lead generations, data collections, and sales. If I ask, many of us, we have several posts on Facebook, very wonderful content. And then you have some people that like it, and you have some people that make comments. But what does that bring to you? Nothing. But the same content, if you turn that content to ebook, you will use that same content to generate email leads. That's what I said. Do that, you be wise. So your write-ups, sometimes make them ebooks. Give people free ebooks. When they are to give you ebooks, they will give you their phone numbers and they give you their email address. That's the way. That's the way to get, so you already get a contact, then you can be able to promote to them. And so, and another free book is events. When you are doing events, make sure you get people's data. Make sure you have their email address and you have the phone number. I'll talk about Eventbrite. I use Eventbrite a lot. And in the course of the practicals, I will show us Eventbrite is very, very good. Every business person should learn to run an event, should learn to do an event. If you really want it, events, doing events is one way of maximizing your content. Because you're able to talk to people, you're able to host people, talk to people about what you do, what they can benefit, they can be able to ask you questions, you're able to answer questions, you can be able to get their data, phone number for follow-up, emails for follow-up. So it's, and of course, Eventbrite is just so wonderful. It's one of the best platforms that I can always talk about every time. So when we get to practicals, I'll be talking to us about Eventbrite. So let's learn to, don't just give out free books. You want to give people data or whatever, get contacts, get something you can use for follow-up, build lead generations, data collections, and then push them to sales. Find something that will make from will bring sales. So I think talk about that. As like I said, as I said, I'll be talking about the event, right? We'll go practical. So the next thing we'll be doing now, I know that it's not everybody that can that like I said, that will run their hearts on their own. But I just need to show you this so that you have that understanding, even if you are employing someone to do it. And then, well, it's good, but for small businesses, because we know that it may not be, it will, looking at the level of things, looking at things here and there in Africa, we've come up with some packages that, okay, you don't have to employ a digital marketer on a full stuff, or growing businesses, small business. So we have some packages on business hub. We have business hub, we created business hub Africa. So on business hub.africa, we have even from managing, creating from website, having small shop, small e-commerce, small office, sizable ones, website and management. We have different plans. You can go to businesshub.africa and you will see different plans that we have there. We're going to talk about that. For those who feel like they don't have the time and they continue, but if you can pay the time together, let them just follow our training. You follow the training, they can, and let them watch this video, discuss with them around it. You can always call, you can always ask me questions, let them discuss around this, and then come up with something. Oh, that's very good. But you think you those this the platform we created will serve for you, but we take all what we do there, we onboard your business online, we help you handle that. We manage your business online, and then we market your business online. So we take the burden of digital away from you while you face other things. All you do is, of course, your only engagement is they ask you questions about your product, or they mix, they sell, and all that's what concerns you. But everything about the digital, we handle it. So we have that platform, you can make your choice, you can be part of it. So I'll be going into the next video, we'll be going to practicals. So, and of course, I'll in the practical, I'll explain some things. Like I said, I will talk about, we'll go into Facebook, then we'll also talk about other aspect, then we'll talk. I want us to use Eventbrite, it will help us. And MailChimp is good as well to send emails. I'll talk about all these tools that you can use for your business. So let's consider this. And I believe that what we are doing, it's really in one way or the other, is really going to help your business. So thank you for times that come your way next in the next video. Thank you. Please, I need us to watch all these videos well, understand this. It's the way we are giving, we are trying to, this is the way we can help, especially for small business. So I wait to hear from you, your questions, or any challenge, or you want to sign up for Business of Africa. Thank you.